come to God. In this way, God showed Abraham that a lamb could be slain as a temporary offering for the forgiveness of sin. That was until God would provide in his new covenant the ultimate sacrifice, Jesus, who was sacrificed to pay for the sins of humankind. So that instead of sin separating people from God, the sacrifice would be a substitute and make possible a restored relationship with God. Many prophets foretold of the coming of the Christ who would bring reconciliation between God and people. The prophets predicted many things in detail about the Messiah, many years before he appeared. The prophet Isaiah foretold that his birth would be miraculous. A virgin would conceive a child who would be called Son of God.
Hey guys, I'm an Old Testament prophet and my name is Micah. I predicted that the Messiah will be born in Bethlehem.
And I am another prophet, Zechariah. I told of the Messiah's entry into Jerusalem on a donkey and of his betrayal by Judas, one of his followers.
Isaiah foretold what the Messiah would do. The Spirit of the Sovereign Lord is on me, because the Lord has anointed me to proclaim good news to the poor. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim freedom for the captives, and release from darkness the prisoners. To proclaim the year of the Lord's favor and the day of vengeance of our God. Let me tell you a bit more of the story. This is what Isaiah told us. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. In the days when Caesar Augustus was Emperor of Rome, and which Herod the Great was King of Judea, God sent the angel of Gabriel to visit the Virgin, a young unmarried girl in the city of Nazareth. Her name is Mary.
Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end.
How will this be, since I am a virgin?
The Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God.
I am the Lord's servant. May your word to me be fulfilled as God wants.
Not long after this, Mary went to visit her elderly relatives, Elizabeth and Zechariah. As Mary entered their courtyard, she called out her greeting. When Elizabeth heard Mary's voice, the baby leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit.
Blessed are you among
But why am I so favored that the mother of my Lord should come to me? As soon as the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the baby in my womb leaped for joy. Blessed is she who has believed that the Lord will fulfill his promise to her. My soul glorifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God, my Savior, for he has been mindful of the humble state of his servant. From now on, all generations will call you blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me. Holy is his name. His mercy extends to those who fear him. From generation to generation, he has performed mighty deeds with his arms. He has scattered those who are proud in their inmost thoughts. He has brought down rulers from their thrones, but has lifted up the humble. He has filled the hungry with good things, but has sent the rich away empty. He has helped his servant Israel, remembering to be merciful to Abraham and his descendants forever, just as he promised our ancestors.
Mary was promised in marriage to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be with child through the Holy Spirit. Because her husband-to-be was righteous and kind, and did not want to expose her to public disgrace, with everyone thinking she had done something she shouldn't. Deeply disappointed, he decided to quietly call off the engagement. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream.
Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to name him Jesus, because he will save the people from their sins. All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet. The virgin will be with child and will give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us.
Joseph, greatly surprised and reassured, did what the angel of the Lord had commanded him and took Mary home as a wife. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman Empire. Everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for him. Shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over the flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified.
Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger.
Suddenly, a great company of heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God.
Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to
Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about. So they carried off and found Mary and Joseph, and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spoke the word concerning what had been told about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. Jesus was born in Bethlehem during the time of King Herod. Wise men from the east came to Jerusalem.
Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw the star when it rose, and have come to worship him.
When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all of Jerusalem. He called together all the people's chief priests and teachers of the law.
Tell me, where this ruler is to be born?
In Bethlehem in Judea. For this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For out of you will come a ruler who will shepherd my people in Israel.
Then Herod called the Magi secretly, and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem.
Don't search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me, so that I too can go and worship him.
Let's give him a round of applause. Thank you to all for that, and thank you to Sarwat and team.